in terms of understanding the definitions. And in this one, I'm going to find a conceivable role. This is okay. I hope example in my best work. That's the best I can give. Put it in context. It means simply to put it define based on this formal community. Mazi kumapesi. So what can be defined based on the context? So I can ask you a question. What is your understanding of the claim that defines water as a tool for cooking? These are the same ones. The context, we don't have to matter in terms of how we use it for. Your answer will be based on okay, matter or figure. So it means you will be selling information that you might get to know here, see, but you know, match or some. Or my match or Japan, Tima Banga Suma Diamond, Tima Cham So. So you are defining water based on the context. So the most organizational behavior can be defined based on the context. Context here, organizational behavior in terms of performance. Let me keep my answer. Context number two, organizational behavior in terms of the organizational context. The way people based on the context. We behave differently, as I've said. We behave differently. Many wrong women behave differently on the way. You met a colleague, you behaved according to this one is the same. You were in a public transport and bus and minibus, whatever, you behaved as a person. You are here, you are changed, you are behaving. So that's what I mean by behavior being shaped by the context. Let me proceed. Last week, I think when we met with my manager, the issues to do with the class. Oh, can I have a diagram? Yeah, let's proceed from there. I talked about classical, human, systems, contingency. I talked about that. The number 10 produced. When I understand, because we are talking about the scope of organizational behavior, and we are talking about the several things here. The starting point should be this. When I can tell you, from the scope, we first got the classical human relational systems and contingencies. That I gave you. For you to understand that, you need to understand the background. The issue of organizational behavior in Africa very bad. If you are a Christian, all the stories in the Bible are about organizational behavior. They are talking about leadership. They are talking about behavior. Starting from those that go to church, that is, starting from the first book, which is called the Genesis, we have a minute of organizational behavior. Genesis, where we are talking about the creation of man in the Garden of Eden, Adam and later by Eve, and then those two people sinned against God. That is organizational behavior. Now, one of the issues of organizational behavior is very complex. If what we are doing here is just to try to understand a little bit about human behavior, we can't exhaust everything. Because even God was shocked by his own people that he created. They sinned and sinned against him in the Garden of Eden. And you can see what he did. I want you to understand that in terms of organization. Because it's already classical human relations, systems, and contingencies. So you can see this background. If we take the background of creation of mankind according to the Bible, what did God do first? And I will say to very democratic. Theocratic nation. Theocratic means ruled by God. God was the direct ruler. He was the direct leader. Banana seed. He uses others. Because another one of them to go full time. So when he put them in the Garden of Eden, look, first he created one person. Then he noted that a human being is a social animal. He needed a companion. That's when he created, according to the Bible, those who believe in the Bible, that's when he brought in the woman. Not knowing that it was the woman who was going to be a source of sin. And something happened. Now, the most important thing from that lesson, before I go into Genesis, the organization of behavior, and why in a classical human relation and so on, this is the one meaning. What did he do? When he did that, he gave them a punishment, and they later on introduced the rules and regulations. There must be some rules and regulations. There must be a structure. There must be a structure. And that's when you go on into the book of Exodus, you have the Ten Commandments. You shall not do this, you shall not do this, you shall not do this. That has to do with the organization. So, Muziwana, I want you to see that if you are a Christian, that type of flow, many Munguana of Tigira Nafe, in terms of understanding his own creation. And for you that know something about the Bible, you notice that when those people were moving out of Egypt back to the promised land, anavutika na wambili in the wilderness. Anavutika na wambili Mungu. Now, what I should understand is, ngati Mungu ama vutika ndi Mungu, the first one vutika vutika na every chief. His own creation, anandirenga in a woman, he still has problems with me. If you remember very well, those that have done a little bit of Bible knowledge, when they were going out of Egypt, going into the promised land, Bagatika and Fajankafu Mogere, another one challenge, they were going to the Timagomba here of Lamoko. Mugutis Munza Mugla, go back. Now, this is what human behavior is all about. They actually challenged Moses to say, oh God, I'm going to put ourselves in that way, this way, and we would have been better in Egypt than going to where we were just before. So, Adam Mugla Moses. To the extent that God said, I'm going to destroy all of them right in the wilderness. This is how complicated you and me are. He created us, but he had problems with us. And he still has got problems with us. So it starts from there. And you notice that the whole Bible can be used to teach organizational behavior. Because the first system of leadership was what we call, what I said is theocratic. Theocratic means God was ruling. Akakumutira kumpondo, amalikira mungkuta akumeleze kutwila. And ya tuso namba ulala katowana la, amajedo mungu, amajedo. Let's choose our own leader. That's when they asked for their own king. And the Bible says the first king was King Saul. And I can't forget the one mungkuta, in your mind, you get some decisions. The first is the king who can make decisions right here. And God advised them to say, Mugabo Kanima Kinzi, Adamba Ukutan, Adamba Ukutan. And this is what happens. Leaders today are there just to use that. So you can see that as a story of organizational behavior. Now, organizational behavior, as I said, has got these classifications. I talked about classical. Not about opening here. Schematic classical. I want to expand on that today. Let's start. Classical, basically, these are the things that you take from that classical. We are looking at the four. You think it's all going to be like this, because the question remains is not very bad to place that in theory, and they are classical. Right. So we are looking at the scope, the
say the English will not be a linear understanding is not the
of this problem again, it's problem the range. The range. In other words, we're going to be one of the organizational behavior, not be the rabbis, in not the rabbis. So they're going to have the scope. For example, in the moment that anybody says it's a problem, we'll talk about the scope of your research, it means how far has it gone. My ambidabas and whom come and is so the evaluation of the scope of organizational behavior is organized. So the scope of OB starts from that. Actually, apart from the biblical beginning, the humble beginning from the Bible, I'm not very sure about the Quran, it will be the same. It talks about the source of human beings. Human beings. When I think one last month, because we are talking about human behavior and how they behave, how people behave, and how their behavior affects the performance of an organization. The difference between an animal and a human being. When I think of two of us, one of the scope of organizational behavior. The main difference is that a human being, you and me, we are also animals. But the animals we are called human beings because we have what is called a human element. I want you to understand this Genesis story. Human element. Animals here, many times human beings like the lion, like the goat, like the dog, anything. I need to eat. And I need to qualify with the literal human being. Now, human element, I'm going to be like a way you're humane. When I write a check with the Bible, more traditionally, humane, I don't know how to learn what it is. Kind, considerate, compassionate. The idea of any words for we are. This is this last device. Humane in the Bible tells you that it has to do with being kind, what you don't know, considerate, organized, and compassionate. So, my animals are in the end. But this is when we talk about animal, to carry food. It's because we're going to be a human element. Now, element in your dinner will deal. I will come and see that. Because it comes from, I'm studying this. So the difference between animals per se and animals called human beings, Timothy and being. So you are a human being because you are supposed to have these things. Did you find that you are under that weird in the Nimbuyo, there are wallets, 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 there human being and it was one being. The difference between an animal and a human being is all these things. In fact, you are very good. Other animals, even in a world, it's a difference. That's why we are called human beings.
We are animals, just like the dog. Come on, to be like it. So I'm going to have a person. So I'm it's because that person is not displaying these qualities, which are differentiating us from this. You know, see, madam, I'm going to go to the jungle. My animals are not in the jungle. And I just have sheep. And I got to go in a bath. To find a dog, if they are going to cut off, you're going to cut off. Who's on the second account? 20 and other than this. They would take up on the job and put a baby cat sword in the corner. Hey, when we take the example, the Bible will be the truth. So we will very consider it. You get out of the hour, my animals are neither the element, the element, the element of control, like a woman's hour, and the baby cat. Therefore, I ask the Maro out. In the jungle, with the Maro sword, which there is no sword in the jungle. The lion will pounce on anything it sees. The snake will bite on anything. It won't stop and say sorry. Never. When a lion comes on an ant or on a snake, it will not stop and say sorry. No one can. But maybe it's dead enough and deep kind of human element. That is what makes us different from these animals. That is why, by extension, the body can come deep group is in a bit of a club jam. Eh, we don't be like this thing and what is. The strongest animal will get the strongest woman. Therefore, one who cannot be the same. What happens in the jungle? We don't have a girl and say, I have a conversation. The strongest dog will get the strongest female. That's the life of the jungle. That's how we that we do never. So, Mungo tells me, I'm not a couple. We have found wife. Come on, who will not actually have human element. Mungo is the one that is not ready to hire a new Mungo. We have one piece and the whole way weak. It doesn't matter, still, because that's right here. That's what it means. So, this is the understood as the genesis of life. Then, from there, Paris campaign, I'm going to go to the organizational behavior. And one of them is this one. William Shakespeare. The first one movement, you're the Caravan organization of history. When you look at William Shakespeare, I remember my family read, but in my play, it's not the rapper. Julius Caesar, Macbeth, you know, some of the central secondary Thailand, Romeo and Juliet, I think I'm not going to play, but what I went to, so this is around 1616 to 1664. Now, if someone was taken by the Mutualism, I have no love on any organization of behavior. All these books, all these plays are about human behavior. All these are about human behavior. So, as far back as 1616, somebody started to think about how people behave, the differences, the trust, the loss of confidence that people have. The confidence that people have. The complication of human behavior, the complexity, think what you're defining, summarize complexity of human behavior. The complexity of human behavior. In Julius Caesar, you have Caesar and you have Brutus. And what is very close to each other. Caesar was the ruler, Brutus was the closest man to Caesar, but he is the one who stabbed Caesar. The complication of understanding human behavior. The people that are more dangerous to you are those that are close to you. That's what this book is about human behavior. The people that are very close to you, those that you regard to be friends, are the most dangerous because you meet them without it. Precaution. So much the day, Roman Mugato is a friend. The person who can kill me easily is my wife. Because the matter of Gona Rulo,
The most dangerous person is my wife. Because if I know that this one is an enemy, it's because I am closer to me. So the people that will betray you are those that are close to you. That's what we are saying. That's about understanding. See how human behavior is shaping us. From the Bible, I believe also from the Quran, to the time that these people started writing plays about human behavior. In Macbeth, it is the wife of Macbeth who is the most dangerous character in the book. Because she has passion for Mamunaga cracking, so they should kill and then he should become the queen. And she's the one who plotted this death of the king, so that Macbeth should become king. And it is this woman who said everything. We do this, we invite the king to our palace, let the guards drink a little bit, and then in the night you take the dagger and kill the king, so that he should become the king. It's the wife, the complex state of human behavior. So you can see in that way. Now, after this, that's when you have the classical. Now, what you know about the classical, you need to explain and add information to what we have already covered. The classical approach. The classical approach these are the most important things. Ignored the critical role. It ignored the critical role of human behavior. And how it directly affects the overall performance of an organization. The fundamental is really what I said last week, the overall performance of an organization. It ignores the critical role of human behavior. Despite the fact that the Bible came early and it told us, we are still against what it was such a big deal. Despite the fact that William Shakespeare might not know the people that we live in, they have an impact, they have an influence. So, classical approach you. It ignores the critical role of human behavior and how it directly affects the overall performance of an organization. Main focus was on improved productivity, strong performance of an organization. The main focus was on improved performance or improved productivity. The classical approach only recognize human beings or human behavior, let's say human beings, in private people or employees, as just components of the production process. And they were referred to as simply as machines. The first, it is ignored. The classical approach ignores the critical role of human behavior and how it directly affects the overall performance of an organization. That's a very important point. Secondly, the main focus
was on improved productivity, strong performance of an organization. So the focus, I think it's a couple of persons in my example, when we were wondering about it, back up and in the classical approach about their business, you know, business administration. You know, if I don't make up a tomorrow business, young, who see a familiar group of young business, even if I'm not the point number two, you got a tiny classical approach. When you think that for your business to do well, it is because of the structure, it is because of the capital you have and nothing else, regardless of the people. This is something that only in the minibus, in my little water, First question I asked for a person and I would come a minibus, you know, win. Some of us only drive anyway. They don't care about the one driving. So the question, I mean, basically, they have nothing to do with the individual or the person. I want you to understand this beginning of those things I gave you. So the main focus was on improved productivity, regardless of the human factor. Okay, maybe. They only recognize the human being. Let's put the human factor. You can go the human factor. They only recognize the human factor or employees or the people as just components of the production process. They were simple machines. As if people don't think. This will be taken more by both our BBA students. Business. That is four. We have the financial and the physical capital. We have the human capital. And you come a capital or the customer capital. Because business over there, customers will not survive. Now, and that to our class people, we're focusing on this. But for you to improve your productivity, for you to improve your performance, you need to focus on the strength in terms of physical and financial capital. You have to have the money. You have to have the infrastructure. You are forgetting this. Before you have business administration, we are definitely going to have a business here school. We are going to have a business here. We are going to have a business here private school. And we are going to have a school. We have seen a lot of businesses with very good infrastructure, come there no students. But I have spoken around about your palm beach. I don't know whether it is operational. But see, this is the problem of businesses. We also have to look at this. Where are we going to get the customers? What will be the human capital? The same point, the people that work in the organization. The
Because these are the people that will make things happen.
Remember, characteristic organization, three characteristics of people. Because people are the ones that make things happen. A good building will be nothing until you have people that will make things happen. That's what it means.
So, the classical approach ignores the critical role of human behavior. They completely thought that human beings are just bad, and that is the only way.
Okay, number four point. Point number four about classical approach. The only way to force people to be productive is to pay fair.
To them, the only thing that will drive people to work is to pay. What a mistake. What a mistake.
So there are these four important points. They ignore the critical role of human behavior and how it directly affects the overall performance of an organization. The main focus was on improved productivity, performance of an organization. They said only recognize the human, it only recognized human, the human factor or employees as just components of the production process, as machines. Amount to the part of the employees just like machines. That they respond to this. You give them something, they work hard. You are getting 50,000, you increase to 60,000, they work hard. Productivity will improve. You give them 100,000, they work even harder. And you just be doing this, then the people will be working hard.
Is there any direct relationship?
But now we know that the organizational behavior has changed this type of thing. It has changed this type of thing.
So, before I end today's lecture, let me mention the following. What you wrote was emphasis was in purpose and formal structure. Emphasis was on purpose and formal structure. And there is a hierarchy of management with technical requirements, and I explained the following. What I would like to ask you to do is the classical approach. The classical approach emphasis was based on obtaining increased productivity, which is one of the pillars I've already mentioned. So the classical approach, I'll just put CA, emphasis was on obtaining increased productivity from individual workers through technical structuring. And provision of monetary incentives, that's point A. We are back for continuing with those ones. And the provision of monetary incentives
had in the classical approach.
So there are two subgroups.
I will give you the two subgroups, and that will be
there are two subgroups of platform approach.
There are two subgroups of the classical approach, shall we put of the CA.
The first subgroup is called the scientific management. To understand human behavior. That's why organizational behavior is so involving. It The manner of human relations, systems approach, contingent approach, we notice that human beings are now taking an important role in any business. Because you cannot program a human being.
So that's what we'll be now looking at. What was the scientific management era talking about the machine field in terms of how they completely disregarded people? They completely disregarded
people. Might be a example, this is demonstration of footage. Kumene ama estate sa kudimuna and pakarika di machine by Banova di u Malawi T-shirt post. Amen.
The guy in the book is Captain Obstinate. I still wish I read that book again. I read it so long ago. The book is not quite there. The human component. I'm not going to go to the book. I'm not going to go to the book. Any organization in Malawi or any other. I'm not going to see the book. Asama kuhisi kwa mbili nchilo ubuntu, kwa mazibu kuhisi nchilo the structure, kwa mazima letera. There is no way kwa mbili nchilo mbili nchilo kuhisi ni kugani na kani mungu, kupa mtani mungu kanga ki something like a machine. No, it's not possible. So in this book, a small novel I was reading, it says, one thing you have to obey commands from your spirit. You have to obey commands. When you are there, what they you supposed to say. Then in this novel, Captain Austin was the captain, another captain, which is Badali of Kapuvaga. Then they were fighting in Russia. Then whatever the captain says, the soldiers have to follow. Don't think like human beings, you have to follow instructions. Now, calling them Buddha one beings, they started retreating from a tower. Then, this captain of the United Soldier, we are the soldier and the soldier that we are not under captain. But we are one of human consideration, kindness. Then, as they were retreating from a tower, the captain had issued an instruction, run away, let's retreat, and let's go back to our base. So they are running. Now, whatever the captain has said has been followed. Now, as they were running, a shot was hit. And when one of these soldiers looked back, and one of the captain had been shot here on the shot, and he was bleeding. Because he put all these soldiers in front, and the captain was at the back. So these soldiers that were following them, the enemy, shot, and the other one on the left, hitting the captain. Now, for army, I'm not going to move his own. The captain said, proceed. Now, this soldier, and I'm going to a human element, and I'm shooting. That captain is bleeding a lot. Within a short time, agua, and my enemies are jumping at the cave. So the soldier turned his back and wanted to assist the captain. The captain was very angry. He said, I have reached my instruction, go forth. Now, you can see the conflict between treating a human being as a machine and treating a human being as a human being. This soldier, this captain has been so good with us. And he was bleeding. So this soldier, for the first time, disobeyed the captain. He said, no, captain, we ran together. The captain said, I've said go. And when you disobey from your senior, it's an offense. But this soldier, private soldier, carried the captain on the shoulder and struggled to run. And you are not safe, but you Marwa was safe place to the fish. The captain was treated, and I'm telling you, when he got well, the first thing he did was to call his soldier and say, I issued an instruction before, you did not. Why did you return? You are fired. So he fired this soldier when he fell. Simply because of not following instructions. So what I'm trying to say is, this theory is completely ignoring the element of the human being. It's just thinking that you are treat human beings just like machines in a production. We'll stop there so that when we meet again, we will continue with this. Thank you again, once again, for coming. I did expect that you will come because of other commitments. Like I said, class is not going to be having a lot of things that you can meet. So we meet again in Monday next week.
Good.
We get back on Monday classes. Yeah, so we meet again on Monday. Thank you so much.
And I'll say tomorrow if you want to see but you will not take the example you want and you will bring back the examination script.
I'm going to go to the next one.
Yeah.
That's a reason. Rest of whom are you?
Concept, you know,